When a small business gets compromised, statistics show us that 60% of those businesses are unable to survive past 6 months. This is because too many have the mindset, I'm too small, it won't happen to me, and those businesses did not take sufficient precautions in order to protect their business. I know many small business owners are planning on selling the businesses to supplement their income when they do retire. If your business is destroyed by cyber attack or ransomware attack, there may be no business left to sell if you don't prepare yourself to bounce back after a cyber attack. Another reason to attempt to reduce your cybersecurity risk of your business is that credit reporting agencies are starting to take into consideration your cyber risk in your business credit scores. A lowering of your credit score may make it more difficult or expensive to borrow money in the future. Let me share some examples of business compromises. First, a relatively minor one. A veterinarian clinic gets hit with ransomware every month. He pays between $600 and $1,000 every month to get his computers unlocked. For 4 months, he did nothing but pay the ransom, which is relatively low compared to more recent incidents. He later called a security expert and upgraded his endpoint security and later had no further issues. Next, a novelty vendor that sold giveaways or swag, you know, mugs, pens, etc. for trade shows that had sales people to cover the entire United States got hit by ransomware, did not have sufficient backups or endpoint security. He struggled to stay in business and rebuild from paper copies. By the 6 month, he and all of his employees were out of business. I know of another established business worth $6 million where everything got compromised in addition to identity theft, and the cyber criminals took everything. He was looking forward to selling his business and retiring. He had to start all over again from scratch. What I'm sharing today does not replace a full risk analysis of your business and outline everything you need to be doing, but even if you start by doing one or two things that I recommend today, you'll be better off than you were before. Also, not all the suggestions I make today will be appropriate for all businesses. Today, I'm going over some cybersecurity ideas for your small business. Of course, we have to keep in mind one size does not fit all. Much of that depends on the nature of your business, your employees, your budget, and what you're attempting to accomplish. Many businesses start with a few Windows computers and go from there. The question you need to ask is, are Windows computers really the best option for my business? A lot of successful plumbers, electricians, home improvement, furniture salespeople use an iPad instead of a computer to record their sales and input customer information and credit cards. An iPad with a rubber protective case and a relatively secure iOS operating system. I've seen these even in an ice cream store. You have to decide if these are right for your business. If most of your employees involves logging into a website using SaaS or software as a service web applications and sending emails, perhaps a Chromebook or a computer utilizing ChromeOS may be relatively reliable, secure, and affordable way for them to go about their daily work. I've also been told that many Amazon employees utilize these for their everyday work. For some time, they were considered so secure that no company offered endpoint security or antivirus for Chromebooks. That has changed in recent times. Now there are several antivirus offerings to secure your Chromebook. Next, email. The vast majority of small businesses have no business attempting to run their own email server. It is time intensive to maintain and monitor security. You're better off utilizing Google's or Microsoft's own offerings. Even then, require everyone in your company to have a relatively sophisticated password of upper, lower case numbers, special characters, and at least 16 characters long. I would also highly recommend utilizing hardware keys. Adding a security key to the mix probably increases your security tenfold. Why would I recommend securing your email so much? First, for many businesses, all your customers are connected through your email. Next, your banking account is connected to your email. If your email gets compromised, you may lose both customers and some of your bank account. Your banking account. If your bank offers two-factor with a security, please set it up and use it. Next, if you do online banking with a commercial account, ask your bank officer if they will reimburse your losses if your computer gets compromised and the cyber criminal empties your bank account. I know of one business paid his investors royalties to the tune of several hundred thousand dollars per month, and his banker said they would not reimburse his losses if his computer got compromised. He went back to writing paper checks. Now, if you have a cybersecurity insurance policy, ask if they will reimburse you for all of your losses if your computer gets compromised and criminals empty your bank account. If not, you probably should be going back to writing checks. I know plugins are convenient, but they're also a major vulnerability in your computers. Two I recommended before for privacy and blocking online tracking are Privacy Badger and uBlock Origin. Avoid obtaining many plugins. Think like this. Every plugin could be opening a new hole in your browser and may even be stealing data, passwords, and other relevant information. Recently, we've also seen a large amount of plugins advertising there for accessing ChatGPT. Many of these are fake, and many have malicious capabilities. Consult an expert before installing similar extensions or plugins. Smartphone applications, the more the merrier, right? Not so fast. Look at smartphone applications as the more you have, the more potential vulnerabilities you have. Games, screensavers, and other utilities can have unintended consequences. Some may even have the capability to steal data, like your two-factor codes or your email or bank account. Do keep the applications updated on a regular basis or when you see updates. Some like to keep their phones for a long time, maybe even a very long time. If your phone no longer has security updates, you should limit it to phone calls, text, and emails, and remove all other apps, or consider purchasing a new phone. If you've been paying attention, you'll find you have one or more updates to initiate every single week. Browsers, operating systems, applications, routers, computers, tablets, and smartphones. If your device no longer supports security updates, you should seriously consider purchasing a new unit. One more thing, consider removing admin rights from all your computers. This will keep your employees from installing applications that could be malicious and sometimes may even keep certain types of malware from being installed. You should have a minimum of 3 backups of your critical computer systems and possibly consider a 4th that should be either offsite or in the cloud. Not all cloud providers are created equal. Do your homework. Ideally, you should store your local backup drives in a fire-resistant safe. When you get large enough or have the budget, consider managed detection and response provider, otherwise known as MDR, that manages your endpoint security and incident response. Later, consider a managed security service provider, also known as a MSSP, that handles all security functions within your organization. Seasoned and trained security professionals are not cheap, but may save your business from severe compromise, are possibly losing your business entirely. This has been your Cybersecurity Tips of the Week. Everyone, please stay safe and secure. Until we see you next time.